Dr. Shoaib, and in this tutorial we will see the significance of cross product in game design. So before discussion, first of all we will see what is a cross product of two vectors. Suppose we have two vector, one is vector A and another one is vector B. So the cross product of these two vectors is represented by this, and the value of this will be So theta is nothing but the angle between these two vector A and B. Okay. Now, what property of the cross product can be used in game design? Basically, if we calculate the cross product of two vectors, and suppose we found another vector C. So the property of cross product says that this vector C will be always in right angle with both the vectors. Okay, it means if suppose there is a vector C, so the angle between A and C will be 90 degree, as well as angle between the B and C will be 90 degree. So it means the resultant vector of cross product will always be at right angle with both the vectors A and B. So we will take the benefit of this property of the cross product in game design. So now we will see how it can be used. Suppose we are developing a game of first person shooter. So in this game, whenever we press left arrow or right arrow, so we can see that the character always move with respect to the facing of the character. It means that this character will always decides its left direction and right direction with respect to the facing of this character. For example, suppose if the character is facing in this direction, okay, so in that case its right and left direction will be like this. And if character is facing in this direction, so the left and right of this character will be here. So how our game engine will decide the direction of the character with respect to left and right arrow? Because as we can see that in FPS, the direction or movement of a character is not hard coded with left and right arrow. Okay, and it always dependent on the facing of the character. So suppose we have a character, okay, and this is the view direction of the character, and suppose it is represented by cap of F. So F is nothing but the unit vector, okay, and if we multiply this unit vector with a magnitude or scale value, so it will represent the a complete vector, because F is nothing but the direction and this is a magnitude. So this complete value can represent a vector. Okay, so here we are focusing with only the direction. So whenever we play with a character, we know that where it is facing, so we always know the direction of its facing, okay, or unit length vector of its facing. So suppose we know the F, and we can always calculate the upward vector of this character. So this up vector is supposed is represented by cap u, and the value of this is suppose 0 1 0. It means that in x and z, in both the direction the unit length vector is 0, but in y direction its value is 1 if we are dealing with y up coordinate system. Okay, so here we can see that if we have a unit length vector f and unit length vector u, okay, and we know that these both the vector are having the 90 degree between them, because f is a u direction of the character and u is a upward direction, which is always will be upward direction of the character. Okay, so suppose the cross product of these two unit vector is returning a value r. Okay, so r is nothing but the resultant direction which can be reflected by left or right arrow. Okay, and this r will always be right angle with u as well as right angle with f, because this is a resultant of cross product of f and u. Now the problem is, as we were not able to calculate the cos theta in case of dot product, and we found a different way to calculate the dot product in xy coordinate system. Similarly, in case of cross product, we have a different method using the coordinate system. So here we can say that suppose we have a vector c, which is nothing but the cross product of a and b. So how we can calculate this operation using coordinate system? So the very easy thing, so the easiest way is just write x, y, z, z, y. We can pronounce it like zz. Okay. Now, write here c, ab, ab. Okay. Now what we have to do, we have to just shift this x, y and z in circular right direction. Okay, so suppose this is x, y, z, so we have to just rotate in circular right direction, or we can say in anti-clockwise. Okay, so now this x will be y, and this y will be z, this z will be x, and again this z will be x, and this y will be z, and always again write c a b minus a b. Okay, similarly we do again anti-clockwise circular operation. So this y will be z, this z will be x, this x will be y, and z will be x. So this is the vector operation of cross product, and it can be used in game design. Okay, so here we can see that we don't need any type of angle theta or any operation which is related to the angle, and we simply we are using the x, y and z coordinate value of vector a and b in order to calculate the x, y and z coordinate of the resultant vector. Okay, so that's it from this video.